I'm going to give you a tour of my warehouse in Wilmot's warehouse, which I have played, as you can see, for 646 minutes and 42 seconds. Okie dokie. So here, as you can see, is my science section. We've got microscopes, firecrackers, the spray paint can that I thought was a lunar lander, moons are science, a thermometer, beakers. These are shooting stars. These are regular stars. Oh my God, no. These vacuum cleaner nozzles. Down here we have photography. So film canisters, cameras. Photography blends into the arts. So we've got paint brushes, paint rollers. I don't remember what I thought these were originally. No, yes, okay. Originally, these were beach chairs with pillows on them. You can see the blue is the arm of the beach chair, the white is the beach chair, and the yellow is the beach. Paint cans. Okay, let's cover the middle because this overlaps. This is also part of the arts. We've got an ink pot, we've got stamps, we've got paper, we've got envelopes, and we've got fountain pens, and we've got pencils. We've also got paper clips. Blending into nautical, where we've got the ocean, we've got a seashell, we've got anchors, diving helmets, night helmets, tall hats, winter and Viking hat. So as you can see, nautical blends into hats. It is thematically linked. Blue and yellow nebulous objects. So jacks, blue cactus, band-aid, wrapping paper, bees. Takes us straight into, what's over here? Oh, mouth themed objects. So of course we have lips, we have fangs, we have Viking teeth, vampire teeth, regular teeth, toothbrush, dentures, tongue, which brings us into nectarines, yellow backwards L, ores. We're getting into miscellaneous blue and orange objects. So triangles, hashtags, pieces of toast, trash cans, arrows, ghosts, squigglies, jacks again. These are labels. They should probably be in the writing section, but they're not. Bombs. So this is yet another miscellaneous section. As you can see, I put some overflow teeth and backwards L's here and miscellaneous things that I only have one of. Let's revisit the middle. So we left off at writing supplies / nautical hats. What we've got here are dog toys. I don't know why they're here. This is a knife. Here we have red miscellaneous objects / insects, I believe. Here are red carrots, umbrellas, things, knitting needles, and butterflies, insects, as of course we tie to the bees, which are right there. Moths, teacups, getting back into the red and white objects here, a flag of some country, red diamonds, blood. These are walnuts, nautiluses, and then miscellaneous. I think this is nautical overflow. As you can see, we've got a lighthouse, some more stylized water, a fish, cliffs, the White Cliffs of Dover, a blue and yellow object. I think here we're seeing some overflow from there. Here are cell phones. Here's some more wrapping paper and, you know, blue, red, and white miscellaneous shapes with a little bit of red and white overflow. I hate me. The Libra sign. Camels. Sorry. Blue and yellow miscellaneous shapes. Here's another shark. See, these used to be camels. I don't think they're camels anymore for me. Here are bananas. We've got three shades of banana. Yellow banana in dull yellow. Purple banana. And I believe somewhere over here we'll find other banana. Oh wow, I'm missing the bright yellow bananas. Well, the more you know. Now here you will see, oh, there's a bright yellow banana. Here you will see the delivery that I have just received and have not put away yet. So some of these things do have homes. Some of these things will just continue to live here. And some of them will go down here. We're gonna start out with roads and construction. Here we have flags, caution signs or yield signs, cones, train signals, a highway, another train related. It reminds me of the Amtrak symbol, so it's here. Pipes, which are construction related, as we all know. Arrows telling you what way to go, because we're safe. On the other side of construction / transit. We have stoplights. We have, I think, another like subway sign. It's a sign. We have wheels. We have bricks because you build with those. Ha ha ha. Now this threw me just now even because I used to think that this was a paintbrush. The brown thing was the head of the brush. The blue thing was the like wood handle of the brush, and the bright yellow was the line of paint that it was making. As you can see, it is in fact a pipe with water coming out of it, which is why it's now in the construction slash tools overflow. With this pipe and this pipe and this light that has been detached from a vehicle, the nuts, more wheels, hair dryers, pins, glasses, scissors, coffee beans, cheese, and lemons. Because food is over here. Here are flowers. Here's a tyrannid. This is the prehistoric section where the Nautilus would be if it weren't an aquatic creature. Here's the Tyrannosaurus Rex. Here is the woolly mammoth. Here are some things. And here is the purple and yellow object section. So we have teardrops, we have cups, we have bowls, we have three types of X's. So here is a subsection of purple and yellow objects, which is called X's, which is why the red and white X's are here instead of in the red and white section. So that's fine. Here's U's, lightning bolts, arrows, scribblies, some sort of bookmark, triangles, skull and crossbones is here. These are wafers, which is why they're at the bottom of the food section. They are edible, I think. This probably belongs in blue and purple and yellow, but I didn't have room for it, I guess, I don't know. Here's a mountain. So this is, we're getting into the travel section, and that's not why these are here, but it is why this is here. A mesa, a volcano. Here is the Buddha. Here is another gate. Here is a map. Windmills. The Christian fish. These are sails, but they're not nautical. Here are more camels. This is the camel section. Now we're getting into the bird section. We have beaks. We have blue bird beak birds, little yellow beak birds, long orange beak birds, curved yellow beak birds. Interesting. Udders. Now we're getting into food. Food slash animal overflow, where you see udders, because those are cows. Milk. Cheese. Here's some more milk. Baskets of food. That's why the cheese, that cheese is here. Baskets. These are tomatoes. Jars of Nutella. Bees. Now we're getting into the trees slash plants. So these obviously are leaves. Pine trees. Mushrooms. Palms. These are trees. Leaves. Trees. Stumps. I think that pretty much covers it. Strategies that I do. So as you can see, I organize things from front to back. Except for here, apparently. But in general, I'll organize things from front to back. Over here in the food section, where things got just really chaotic for a while, you'll see overflow udders at the very, very back of my milk section. And that's because I need space to maneuver here. I probably won't need to grab all of these udders, but if I need to, I can just grab these ones. In a stock take, I would then organize the other udders and bring them down if I ran out of these udders. And that's, I think, why these birds are all the way out here, because I could push them in. But then, in a busy delivery, I would have to come all the way down here and then be like, oh fuck, where are my birds? Oh, they're back here. Get these. Bring them out. Oh, fuck. No. 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 Anyway, that's why I leave these here. So that is my warehouse. This is how my brain looks inside.